Welcome to Old Ways Gardening and Prepping. My name is Teresa. I'd like to welcome you to my backyard this beautiful late evening. And today we're going to plant ginger. This is my third and final bed that I was blessed to build. And now I'm going to plant some really pretty ginger. I'm going to move the camera so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, let's get busy. Now, half of this raised bed is going to be the ginger, and the other half is going to be a different video. Now, ginger absolutely loves to be well fed. So there is a lot of compost, a lot of cow manure, chicken manure, a lot of this dirt. The soil is really nutrient rich. And that way you'll get stronger and more ginger. Of course, now ginger is also a medicinal as well as a culinary plant, herb, whichever way you want to call it. It is a tropical plant, so you're going to need to harvest it before the first frost. But we've got a while here before that happens, hopefully. All right, let's get started. Now you're gonna want to bury them at least 3 to 4 inches deep.
Good root growth, I always add bone meal. Finally was able to get me some epsom salt. That in lightly so you don't burn your roots. And it makes them grow better roots because they have to search for the nutrients.
And like this one, you can see that it's starting to grow up. You're going to want to make sure that is facing up. It's the same as planting potatoes. Plenty of roots. Mound mine a little bit, that way I know where each of my rows are. Now, the reason I plant mine just a little deeper than most people is I want to make sure that they do not get sun scald, because this is going to end up being an all-day sun bed. They're going to love the heat, but if the roots come to the surface or the tubers come to the surface, they can get sunburnt. Kind of same like a green potato.
And since all I have left is little pieces, which will work just as fine, I'm going to make them into one row.
I'm looking forward to these growing. Alright, done with planting ginger. I've got four really good rows. Alright, excuse me a minute while I grab the water hose. Okay, sorry about that. Now we're going to water them good. Now they like to stay slightly moist, but not soggy. And now that we're finally supposed to have some warm days, hopefully they will pop up pretty quick. And they'll get at least about this tall in the bed. They're a beautiful tropical plant. Now you can grow them up north, but I would grow them in big planting pots. That way you can bring them indoors. And you'll know your ginger is ready because its stems will start to die back. Basically, the same as growing potatoes. Except that potatoes can take cool weather. I said I was going to plant half the bed. I planted a little more than half. But that's okay. Okay, see how simple and easy that was to do? Anybody can do this. You don't have to build them, plant them in a raised bed. You can do them in big planter pots as well. Just make sure that your soil is extremely fertile with a lot of good broke down manure, and especially bone meal. I've done just a little bit of blood meal, that way the leaves will grow better, because it's the leaves that bring the nutrients down to the roots and cause the roots to grow. It's basically the same way for potatoes, garlic, a lot of your root crops. I hope you find this video inspiring and that it motivates you as well to try your hand at growing ginger as well, because we absolutely love ginger. And I love pickled ginger and candy ginger. I could keep going. And ginger is also very good to use in fire cider and also cough syrups as well. Please click the bell notification so that you'll be notified when I upload another video. I hope everyone has a blessed evening. Take care, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video.